Especially when you look at how the parliamentary proceedings went in the monsoon session, there were a lot of disruptions, especially on the side of the opposition. But if there was one particular subject where the opposition was almost united, it was when the 127th Amendment to the Constitution was passed, which allows the state to sort of describe their own OBC categories. It gives them that kind of a power. Now, a lot of experts say that this will have a huge impact on the UP elections. Was this done in mind keeping the UP elections, and how do you think, as a political analyst, is going to impact the elections?
Well, everything is not done keeping in mind the elections. Let's be very clear. There are certain issues which have the broad spectrum support, and the certain issues which must be done irrespective of the electoral calculations. And this amendment was part of it. The OBC category or the other backward classes, is very localized. It's very difficult for the central government to, do this kind of exercise of inclusion and exclusion in different states. So it's better to leave the judgment on the respective states itself, because you have certain castes which are under OBC in one state, they're not under OBC in another state. They're OBC in only they fall under OBC in only certain parts of the states and so on. So the state governments are best suited to take this kind of decision and make this kind of calculations and judgments rather than the central government. So this was the thinking behind passing this amendment, and this also shows the commitment of the Modi government to the federal structure and the federal polity of India to have more empowered local units which can take decisions democratically.
Please remember to subscribe to us and switch on the notifications for this channel. For our other social media links, more content, and to support our work, please visit citti.net. Dhanyavaad. Namaskar.